seventh award of excellence, Liberty and Peace, Jean Nussbaum and Eleanor Roosevelt. Su Excelencia, His Excellency, Professor Adama Dieng, Undersecretary General, United Nations Special Advisor to the Secretary General on the Prevention of Genocide, Mr. Undersecretary General, it is a great honor and I'm having today to express our recognition for your outstanding activity, as well as for a considerable number of publications in the field of legal and human rights accomplished throughout your career. Mr. Dieng not only is a great expert, but he's an excellent person. At times, he did not hesitate to put his life on the line in order to accomplish difficult missions for peace, security, boiling areas like Rwanda, Syria, Iraq, Nigeria, and so on. He's a tireless promoter of the new initiative for justice and compassionate supporter of the non-governmental organizations that are committed to the same goals. I have to say special thanks for being one of the most important actors who contributed to the realization of the present Global Summit for Religion, Peace and Security. For all this and much more, on behalf of the International Association for the Defense of Religious Liberty, on the occasion of the celebration of 70th anniversary, I am pleased to confer on you this International Award of Excellence as an Ambassador for Liberty and Peace, Jean Nussbaum and Eleanor Roosevelt. I congratulate you. I invite Professor Adama Dieng.
Thank you very much, President Brito. Thank you, Secretary General Olteanu. I'm really moved receiving this award. I should say that this is an award I'm going to share first and foremost with my wife and my children, who really have been extremely supportive. Sometimes I feel guilty not spending time with them, but running around the world. But I also would like to share it with all of you in this room. I mean, I don't think really I should be singularized for this prize, because we all have been working hard. But let me simply say one last thing. 70 years ago, the AIDLR, through the acronym in French, the International Association for the Defense of Religious Liberty, pioneered the fight for the respect of religious liberty. And having had the privilege to meet some of your former honorary chair, Edgar Faure, who was the former President of Council of France, Leopold Sédar Senghor, who was the president of my own country, Senegal, may their soul rest in peace. And finally, my good friend, Mary Robinson. I cannot but say these champions of human rights and social justice, if they have accepted to join you, it was for a purpose. And I'm so proud to follow through and to continue to work closely with you. And allow me simply to invite you to convey my heartfelt and unwavering support to all the members of your institutions at the local, national, regional, and international level. The work you are doing is so important, and I can speak on behalf of all the participants in this room that we will continue this journey with you. Thank you very much again.
Thank you so much.
International Awards of Excellence. Liberty and Peace, Jean Nussbaum and Eleanor Roosevelt. Dr. Eduardo Vera Jardim, President of Portuguese Religious Liberty Commission. Besides his extensive expertise as a lawyer and politician, which took him to being appointed as a Minister of Justice in 2011, Mr. Eduardo Vera Jardim is one of the authors who pioneered the law for religious liberty in Portugal. This law, also called tax assignment, has been in force in Portugal since 2001, and it allows taxpayers to assign certain percentage of their taxes to the support of religious organizations. Later on, considering Portugal was an example of best practice on matters of religious liberty, integration of immigrants, he encouraged his government to share their experience with the international forums and the community of Portuguese language countries. Today, I'm pleased, Dr. Eduardo Vera Jardim, to give, on behalf of the International Association for the Defense of Religious Liberty, on its 7th anniversary, this International Award of Excellence as an Ambassador for Liberty and Peace, Jean Nussbaum and Eleanor Roosevelt. With that, Dr. Vera Jardim, here.
Thank you very much for the Association of Religious Freedom, for the Defense of Religious Freedom, for this award. As you have said, I am a lawyer and I was a politician. In my country, if you speak of lawyers and politicians, you speak of bad people, not good people. And if you mix the two things, then the result is very, very bad. But sometimes in our life, also because of our education, some politicians have the opportunity to take a right decision. I was not alone, as I have said some minutes ago. In this work, I had some sort of support, and I can say you that you can count on the new Secretary General of the United Nations, because he was much involved in this battle, because it was something that has taken 5 years to be completed, 5 years. For a law to be completed is not very easy. But I think it was at the time the right decision, and I am very honored with your decision to give me the award. But I think this award is more also for all the people that during many, many years have fought for religious freedom in Portugal. As a matter of fact, our friends of Spain have had 40 years of dictature, but we had also 40 years of dictature, and a dictature that has had many faces, not only a political face, but also other faces. Freedom of expression, freedom of religion, and many other faces. And this year, we complete 15 years of the law. It is also some thing that we commemorate. But I wanted, with this I terminate, I wanted to give you my best award for the work you have done for 70 years. When we speak of 70 years, we are speaking of the immediately after war. That was a time of hope. And now I doubt if we are in a time of hope. But with your work and of other institutions that are also working for the freedom all over the world, for peace, solidarity, I think that we can fight this battle and at the end have a victory with your help and of all the people that are fighting for freedom all over the world. Thank you very much.
International Awards of Excellence, Liberty and Peace, Jean Nussbaum and Eleanor Roosevelt. His Eminence, Shaykh Muhammad Al-Yaqoubi, Syrian Islamic scholar and religious leader. Since the start of the Syrian uprising, Mr. Al-Yaqoubi has campaigned internationally to provide humanitarian aid for Syrian refugees. In December 2012, he led a convoy for the delivery of vast quantity of food, baby food and blankets to displaced Syrian and Turkey. After his exile from Syria in Morocco, he has taken part in the sustained international effort to provide aid for the Syrian people. He has publicly urged the international community to implement help immediately. I finish the quotation on Syria. Mr. Al-Yaqoubi advocated against the misinterpreting Islam into a religion of harshness, brutality, torture and murder. End quotation. In order to encourage and to thank His Eminence to continue his peaceful efforts and his continued support in favor of Syrian refugees, the International Association for the Defense of Liberty on its 70th anniversary has decided to concede Mr. Al-Yaqoubi the International Award of Excellence as Ambassador for Liberty and Peace, Jean Nussbaum and Eleanor Roosevelt.
I'm speechless. The best I could say is my work is insignificant compared to the work of everyone amongst you and many behind, whether for the establishment of peace or for reconciliation or for humanitarian aid or combating extremism. It's a great honor for me to be given this award from the International Association for the Defense of Religious Liberty on the 70th anniversary. And if I am to say anything, I would like to say two things. First of all, with such figures and beautiful statements and great leadership we've seen from everyone here and from what I read and heard from previous meetings, I have a lot of hopes for better future for all religious communities and non-religious communities around the world. The second is a commitment to continue our work. I have been recently put on ISIS hit list. But this would never prevent us. It gives us better motives to go and fight extremism and build peace. And by the way, when we fight with peaceful approaches. We fight with beautiful prayers and preaching. That's the way we fight. We fight with an exchange of love. That is to say, they fight us with bullets. We fight them with roses. Thank you for this great opportunity. It's a great honor for me, and congratulations.
Integral word of excellence, liberty and peace, Shaykh Nussbaum and Eleanor Roosevelt. Dr. Bruno Vertallier, former president of International Association for the Defense of Religious Liberty, Switzerland. Dear Dr. Bruno Vertallier, because of your constant care for the most unprivileged people, in consideration of all your untiring commitment to educate the youth, to train the trainers, and acknowledging your firm support to the whole activity of the association in defending the freedom of religion and belief as a principle for all people, even after you took different responsibilities upon your shoulders, we are more than pleased to confer to you the International Award of Excellence as an Ambassador for Liberty and Peace, Shaykh Nussbaum and Eleanor Roosevelt, on this 7th anniversary of the International Association for the Defense of Religious Liberty.
Well, thank you very much for this award. I appreciate, and I've been very happy to serve in this facility as president of our association, and to have wonderful people to work with, and especially today, I have been uplifted. My mind has been uplifted by what I've heard. It's true that we have great challenges. Conscience and liberty of religion and freedom is never finished. And probably we will still have, we will have a lot to do. But we want to do it with our heart. We want to do it with love and respect for all the people we are going to meet and educate, teach. Young people, like it was said, we need more young people in our midst. And this is the present, this is the future, and this is our all. So thank you for all of you being present today and for your participation. And I'm sure that we have great days in front of us and that many good things will happen in our world to have a better humanity. Thank you very much.
International Award of Excellence, Liberty and Peace, Shaykh Nussbaum and Eleanor Roosevelt. Dr. Ricardo García, former deputy for the Minister of Justice in Spain on relations with religions and churches, current Vice-Rector General of Strategic Planning for the Catholic University of Valencia, a good friend of all the minorities in all the Christian and non-Christian from Kingdom of Spain. Mr. García has proved to be a relentless advocate for an equitable treat of all the minority religions in Spain, for how he did and how he's doing teaching the students today. We offer to Dr. García, the International Award of Excellence, Liberty and Peace, Shaykh Nussbaum and Eleanor Roosevelt. Dr. García.
Esto ha sido una
sorpresa. This was a surprise for me. As all awards, and whenever somebody receives an award, the first question is, really, is it, do I deserve it or not? I should say yes, perhaps, because I should not have stood to collect the award. But it is true also that in my predecessors, the ex-minister of Portugal, Vera Jardim, for example, he received this award in representation of the whole team that worked with him. Here, the pyramid is the other way around. I am receiving an award of many people. It's a team of many people that have worked with responsibilities much higher than mine. And it is also true that there were several ministers in the Ministry of Justice in Spain that they were determined to develop this law, but there have been several secretaries of state and ministers of justice and several director generals that have worked and learned from. The last one, for example, I am going to mention is Javier García Herrera, that he should be here really collecting this award better than me. There's many other colleagues in the Foreign Affairs, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, for example, Belen. I want to think that because I am the last in this chain, the award is more appropriate for my work as an academic, as a professor, teaching or trying to teach religious liberty in the different universities. It is true as well that the main right of religious liberty has always been my focus, especially what happened with the law in Portugal. For example, other people that have not received an award so far, like Jorge and Fernando, but they have worked together with them, and I have learned many things from them. It's many years ago since I finished my degree in law. I'd never thought that I would have a public responsibility. As the ex-minister, we didn't think that you could help in the way that we have been able to from the Ministry of Justice to so many people. And I would like to mention that what we have discovered is that behind when a lawyer, a legal person speaks in public, there are many, many people behind that have decided to behave and to stand up for some principles and some beliefs that they understand that make them a better person. And that is true. It's not only true, but that they become better people, but they make us better people too. So thank you so much. We don't see a special emphasis from the media to empower people, to make them better. It doesn't matter. The fact is that summits like this, we can emphasize and we can find the true value of those people who are every day, each day, fighting for religious liberties, because when we have international organizations like these ones, when they defend those beliefs in the international arena, and those who do not defend these human rights are the ones that are being exposed. These are prizes, awards that we are not receiving. They are those who have certain beliefs, who can act freely and express freely those beliefs. Thank you very much on their behalf.
Thank you so much. International Award of Excellence, Liberty and Peace, Jean Nussbaum, Eleanor Roosevelt, National Chamber Choir, Madrigal, Marit Constantin. National Chamber Choir was founded in 1963 by conductor Marin Constantin and is one of the most appreciated professional choirs, a symbol of Romanian and universal musical life, and in 50 years of continued artistic existence in name represented Romania in the world, thus becoming a real country brand. Madrigal Choir is unique through its specific sonority, stereophonic placement on scene, medieval Western European costumes, recently and its repertoire that includes European Renaissance music, traditional carols, Byzantine documents, contemporary Romanian compositions, universal music for various creation periods and vocal instrumental chamber works. The National Chamber Choir Madrigal, in its 5 decades of artistic life, has performed over 4,100 concerts in Romania, in the famous chain in Europe, US, Japan, Turkey, Korea, etc., winning international music critics' praise and receiving numerous Romanian awards and honors, culminating with the UNESCO World Heritage List and the Grand Order of Commander, awarded by the President of Romania in 2003. With a record of 46 albums, as well 24 short films in TV movies, Madrigal have been bringing their message of hope and peace to a large audience. In memory of their founder, Mr. Marin Constantin, and for celebration of 7th anniversary of International Association for the Defense of Liberty, as the Secretary General, I invite you to receive the International Award of Excellence as Ambassador for Hope, Liberty and Peace, Jean Nussbaum, and Eleanor Roosevelt. I invite Dr. Anna Ungureanu and the manager, Emil Pantelimion, to come here.
Ladies and gentlemen, Your Excellencies, we are very honored to be here today on such an important occasion. We truly believe that peace and multiculturalism are very important for our present world. This award is a great symbol for our activity and tradition, as it comes to support the values that made our repertory and choir a Romanian national ambassador in the world. Thank you, and may we all live in a world where music brings peace and fraternity. And now the music will bring us together.
hear more music. Yes, more music up there. Now it's very late. We have to leave the room, but we can hear a whole concert tomorrow, Thursday. We're starting at 6:15. We would ask you to register with our secretary tomorrow until noon, the latest. We need to send a list of all the activities to the concert tomorrow morning. So thank you for your attention and have a good night. I think one of our
Can I just a question? I would like to invite all the our ambassadors that take an hour to come here for an official picture. Thank you very much.
Make a big picture of all the missions.
Yeah, all the ambassadors that receive an award. Thank you.